Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 3 with just the bow. Today we're going to clean up some stuff we've missed before we push on. So let's start with Mr. Swordmaster here. That was a goofy miss. There we go, right in the noggin. He's going to come straight at us. Alright, this guy. Normally I would fight this guy pretty early on, but I was worried about not having enough arrows for this guy, or enough damage to fight him. But I think I may have waited a little bit too long, because I kind of feel like he's going to be... holy smokes, bud. I was just about to say it seemed like it might be pretty easy. Sheesh. Oh yeah, he's going to back up because I think I'm too far away. Oh, I forgot to use that undead bone shard. Go for a dash shot. Because he's just not paying attention to us at all. Alright. Yeah, he's not that... when he's attacking me, he's deadly, but... Thankfully, he just wants to kind of goof around and be goofy a lot. He's got a lot of arrows in him right now. It's one thing I love about using the bow. Makes everybody look hilarious. What are you doing? I'm not over there. Go for another roll. Oh, nope. I was going to go for a rolling shot, but for some reason I just stood up and decided not to do that. Come at me, bro. Come on. There we go. Well, that's the Swordmaster. If you defeat him before you kill Vort, you can actually summon him to help you fight Vort. You can get the Master's Attire and some Uchi Katana, which is a cool bleeding katana that guy uses. Anyways, we got a Crystal Lizard back in the tutorial area to fight, so I'll see you there in a second. Here we are at the Crystal Lizard. We're gonna take this guy on and see how it goes. I don't think it'll be too bad. Like I said, we're just with the... Master guy. I just didn't have enough arrows to fight these guys when you start the game, because I needed all 30 of them, well, 29 of them for Mr. Gundyr, and as you can see, even with all my upgrades now, well, not a ton of upgrades, I still take quite some time to actually kill this guy. Make sure I don't just die to something stupid. I heal up just in case. I like to play it safe. Alright, he's gonna roll at us. I think if you're using a melee weapon, you can actually stagger this guy and do like a riposte on him. But I don't know if you can stagger people with the bow so much. You probably can if you hit their weak spot over and over again. But it might be difficult. Jeez, whoa, two layers of crystals. Oh, wah! That wasn't good. Alright, careful. Yeah, I'm just gonna heal here, just in case. I just don't want to get dropped by something like this. Just because I didn't know I was on the wall there. I didn't get hit, but that was close. Alright, there we go. Get a titanite scale for that. I don't know if there'll ever be a bow we can upgrade with the titanite scale, but we'll see. Anyways, I'll see you at another bonfire in just a moment. The Road of Sacrifices is our new destination, and we're gonna be heading on into this area once again, shooting arrows at everything. These guys, I honestly have no idea. Oh, well, I'm starting to get an idea of how this is gonna go. Holy smokes, that was rough. Well, in between the area I just left you at, the Crystal Lizard, and this place, I spent my souls on as many standard arrows as I could carry, which turned out to be 622 is what I needed to fill my entire item storage capacity. Jeez, these guys are brutal. Holy smoke, I'm gonna die. I'm dead. I'm just dead. 100% dead. Alright, well, back to what I was saying. I filled up my item storage with all the standard arrows I can carry so I can do a little bit more damage as often as I like. I spent a couple of them in levels, so I have a little bit more health, a little more endurance, and I also got one more drawing out of my true strength, so I have another dark sigil, because I died once or twice or something like that. So I have two of those now, so I'm a little bit higher level. I'm 26 now. Still no improvements in my dexterity or anything like that, though. So let's continue to wipe these guys out. Hopefully none of them go berserk on me like the other ones did. See if that attack had hit me. Oh man, these guys are such a pain in the butt. Have to manually aim this guy then? That seemed to work. Oh jeez. I always have to rush these guys down when I'm playing with a normal weapon. Or a melee weapon, I suppose. The bow isn't really abnormal. It's just a bow. Got two more, and one of the caster variety of these guys up here. So let's see if we need to wipe one of them out before this becomes a complete and total nightmare. Come on. Okay, we got one. Alright, going for two. Going for two. Give me some headshots. Give me some headshots. There's one. That wasn't a headshot, but close enough. Close enough. Alright. And last guy here. I thought these guys wouldn't be nearly this bad. I forgot how ridiculous they can be, though. I mean, I thought this place would be kind of tough, but I figured, like, yeah, you know, like, you know, 5 minutes maybe. Maybe like 8 minutes to get through this area. No, this is brutal. But using my range to my advantage in these scenarios, we have a NPC player type character up here. A wary of tough enemy, that message said. We got a brigand axe and someone wielding a butcher knife, a giant butcher cleaver, and walking very slowly. Good timing on that block, though, gotta say. Alright. Shouldn't be too tough. Oh, that attack has a little bit more homing. Oh my gosh, that range and speed, though. It's too good. Too good. Every time, I just gotta stop saying things are gonna be easy, because as soon as I think that something's not gonna be too bad, that's when it gets really bad. Oh, sorry, that was my dog there. Oh, getting a shot there. Oh, smack. Go for a shot. Missed it. Take that one. Oh, that might have been bad timing. I don't mind if you throw dung piles, it doesn't really affect me that much. That rolling attack, that weapon is just brutal. This person has no armor. Well, maybe a little bit of armor, but nothing else really. Alright, I'm just gonna go for a rolling shot. Not quite enough damage. Oh, there we go. Alright, I think we get a weapon for that. Yeah, the butcher knife, there we go. It is a butcher knife. And it's damn deadly. That thing is brutal. Pretty good weapon if you want to be strong, I guess. I mean, everybody wants to be strong. I want to be strong with the bow, but I can't seem to find enough titanite shards to get upgrades. We got some armor and twin daggers there. We might end up using the brigand armor. As you can see, I changed the outfit a little bit here. Holy smokes, my dog is just like groaning and moaning over here. Just wants his head rubbed. But yeah, I got some new threads going on. I tried to reduce my overall equip load so that I get more benefit from the Flynn's Ring, so I get more damage from having a lower equip load. But I didn't want to lose all the armor, so I think I'm only wearing a chest and pants right now. And now's not a great time to talk about what attire I'm wearing. Holy smokes. At least these guys don't have little knives, so they don't go absolutely as berserk. But jeez, this area is harsh. I think this is going to be a one-trip-through kind of area, so I'm just going to get all the treasures I know about here. And if I miss any, well, so be it. I'll come back when I have better stuff. Well, that was an air shot. Cool. Stop points. Maybe, I don't know. It was auto-tracking. I didn't do anything special. Alright, heal up again. Just because you can never be too safe. Hey, a titanite shard. Alright, there's still a couple more treasures that I know of. I have to fall off this bridge here. No, not this one, sorry. A different one. And then you can get a spell book, I think, and a ring. So we're gonna go with those. And, should I even... Yeah, I'm gonna have to fight these guys, or at least run through or something, so... Maybe I should take advantage of whatever I can. These guys make such weird noises. Sounds like a radio signal dying or something like that. It's just ridiculous. There's a couple of dogs, as you can see. There's one. Just gonna try and shoot these guys. Because these dogs are a little bit different than regular dogs, as far as I know. You can see they have like giant sacks underneath them and stuff. And if they actually jump on you and like land on you or pin you in a certain way, oh my gosh, just don't. Oh, well. Yeah. Oh, and then a screech. See you in a second, guys. And here we are once more back where I died. I fought my way back here, and there's my souls. And let's not die to the doggies this time. And also not to whatever is above us. Okay, let's get this. Let's do this. Shoot the doggie. Shoot the doggie again. Come on, one more. Run in. Yeah, ran into it. Alright, there's one more. And I think the one over here is I'm not sure if they're entirely the same. And this one looks a little bit more normal, actually. So, yeah, that one wasn't as bad, but this one can, like, jump on you and maul you and trap you, and there's a Braille Divine Tome of Kareem. So we can give that to the blind faith-teaching lady. And Morn's Ring, which improves the power of faith stuff. And this guy has red eyes. I didn't remember this guy having red eyes before. But, take him out. Come on. I think what happened... Oh. Okay. That was easy. I think what happens with the bow with those guys, I'm not sure if it's like a glitch or something. Let's see if we can... if I can recreate what I'm talking about here. I thought there was one of those guys, like, right around here. Did he oh, there's one. Let's see. If I start hitting him, he's gonna transform, right? But as soon as I hit him the second time, he fully transforms. He doesn't actually, like, go through the whole sprouting of all of his wings and everything. So I think when you hit him with a ranged attack, oops, he just goes through the full animation instantly. So these guys just start flying at you really fast. They don't go through the whole animation that I like to use. It's time to kill them, really. But hey, we made it. We made it through. Oh, there's an ember back there. I can't leave a treasure behind. Hold on, Henri. I have things to do. There's a guy up here guarding an ember. I don't know if I'm going to fight him, but I'm going to take that ember. Yep. Thanks. See ya. Alright. Onwards to Henri. You can yell all you want. I'm down here by a bonfire. I'm good. I'm good. Thanks. Alright, here we are. Ember up. Or not ember up, on fire up. Might as well restore all our arrows and Estus and everything and go talk to our buddies over here. This is Henri. I'm not gonna really listen to anything that he has to say because we're not doing this for the story. We're just here to shoot things. Horus gives us the blue sentinels, so now we can protect people. And you know what? I'm an honorable kind of justice-seeking kind of guy with my bow. I'm like a Robin Hood type character, maybe. Or maybe I just want more souls. So we'll see. If we get summoned to protect any would-be victims of heartless invaders. Those scumbags. But we'll see. I might ever get summoned. I don't tend to get summoned for these things. I don't know if I'm just not in the right levels or my connection's just bad. I don't know. Anyways, we're going to go this way first because we have some treasures I want to get to and a couple of fights I'm eagerly looking forward to. So, let's clear the way. Oops, that arrow just went nowhere. And usually I like just walking up to these guys with a big sword, or even just a straight sword, and just wiping them all out. So satisfying. This game could use more, just like hordes of enemies, in my opinion. Like lots of little guys that don't like do a whole lot, but if they get an attack off on you, then they're deadly. That would just be... I don't know. Maybe that's a bad idea. Maybe people are already like, no, don't do it. That's terrible. But I think it's satisfying to just take out a whole bunch of baddies at once. Right in the face. This guy is just the right angle for the lock-on to just put the arrow right in his noggin. Don't bite me. These guys can be kind of nasty. As you can see, they're pretty quick. And I think if they get their like lunging grab attack on you, then they get powered up somehow. They get like a blood infusion or something. They get even more enraged and faster. So it's like a downhill battle, or an uphill battle if they start hitting you and get that ability on you. Oh, see, he's already awake. He's already awake and coming at me. Come on, buddy. Let's fight. Let's fight, but I want to win. So you be aggressive and stuff. Not too aggressive. I want to keep moving through this area. You're not the guy I'm looking forward to fighting. Let's heal up, just in case. Oh my, jeez, he can jump so far. Like, I want that kind of power. He's so strong. Jeez. Right. Don't be too aggressive. Run on my part. Oh, ah. Okay, I just need to do like a quick roll. But be careful. Alright. Went for the extra roll, just in case. I wasn't gonna risk it. Especially because he can take about half my health in one go. That's just insane. So, this is the guy I'm looking forward to fighting. This is the Black Knight here. With his friggin' giant greatsword. Shoot him right in the noggin. Come on. Come at me. Let's do this. Alright, I'm gonna use my range, because that's all I got. And he's gonna use his range, because he has everything. And his speed, and his giant sword. I want him to attack so I can get away and get more timing. I find with this, with the bow, you have to really, like, if you don't want to just cheese everything and stand as far away as possible, you really have to, like, bait out as many long animation attacks as you can, go away, get enough time for a shot. Like, I would do all roll shots, but it just does such less damage when compared to a regular shot. Oops. But that's the risk, of course, is that you just get dunked. You just get dunked. Round 3. You might be wondering where round 2 is. Well, I'll probably put a little clip of it in the corner because it was abysmal and short, so I just cut it out entirely. So let's go ahead round 3 here, and hopefully it doesn't go like round 2. Closer to round 1, except ending in a victory for me, and I don't know why I didn't just grab my souls right off the bat there. Ooh, no, this is bad. Alright, get the souls. Alright, let's go down here a bit. Not too far, because I mean, running away from him doesn't really solve any of my problems. I have to fight him eventually. Maybe I can just work him down with rolling shots and stuff. Don't know why I'm using my wood arrows instead of my standard arrows. Definitely need to start using the standard arrows. Alright, that's the attack that really is dangerous for me, I think. Is the thrust. Those attacks always seem to catch me off guard. They're so fast, they're so deadly. They have a lot of range like that. It's just insane. So, that looks like... Oh, that was a big one. I'm glad I just got the heck out of there. As soon as he starts doing any kind of animation is the time I need to start moving away. Ooh, that was a good rolling shot. Yeah, as soon as he starts doing like anything, I need to start backing up. Hey, these rolling shots are really working out for me, right? Oh, he's got so many arrows coming to the top of his head. This is great. Oh, that was probably a bad time to do one, though. That was a good time to do one. And that was a good time to do one. Alright, victory over the Black Knight. Right on, that's great. That took a couple deaths, though. And getting back to this guy, like, it was hard. Those chomping guys with the things on their backs that go nuts, they almost got me a couple times. Thankfully, they didn't get me, but... It was close. Didn't lose my souls. I actually have quite a few more souls now, making my adventure ever the more dangerous. Just picking up a couple more treasures here. Got some cell sword equipment. I don't think I'll be using any of that stuff because I like to use the setup I have right now. But that might change. Maybe I'll become a heavy armor archer. That might be kind of interesting. But for this next part here, we're actually just going to make a mad dash to a bonfire because there's not a whole lot in this area to witness until we go exploring it next time, but I wanna make it to a better spot to start the adventure from, so let's just make a mad dash through here. I'm not gonna get any of the treasures because I wanna give them their own kind of special attention, and we hopefully will make it. This is kinda not going as well as I expected it to. We have a dog here. Oh, I forgot the dogs are a big pain with the bow. We're dead. We're probably gonna end on a death here, guys. Alright, let's get the heck out of here, get sight on that dog. Alright, doggy. No! Oh no. I should have touched the bonfire. That's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye for now.